Sure, the Linux terminal is incredibly powerful, but even I think there are some commands that make me scratch my head. Why does this even exist? Well, probably because it was useful once upon a time and it's just a relic. But these are the five most pointless Linux commands still available today. So yes, the eternal affirmation. The yes command endlessly repeats the word yes, whatever string you give it. Why? Nobody knows. Well, actually, it was really helpful for automating back in the day. So unless you're automating prompts or scripts, it's basically the command line equivalent of a broken record. So it's good for pranks and mesmerizing infinite loops. So for instance, I could write out the following, yes, no, and now I get the word no printing forever. So pointless, kind of, right? Next up, factor. Number crunching, potentially for no reason. So factor gives you the factors of a number. That's it. No explanation, no flair, just pure math. So unless you're doing a last minute math homework in your terminal, this is like bringing a ruler to a laser cutting workshop. So I could type in factor 42, and there we go, I've got the factors of 42. So I don't know what to say. It's one of those commands that is there, and it's kind of pointless these days with all the powerful tools we have at our disposal, but it's a hangover from the past, so it's kind of fun in its own right. Now let's talk about rev, the backwards text wizard. Yep, rev takes your input, flips it around. Because I don't even know. It's a one-trick pony that reverses text, and that's it. I guess the practical use cases are palindromes, maybe. We've all come across palindrome checkers in our technical interviews and other kind of data algorithms and things like this. So, you know, if you've ever done data structures and algorithms and you've ever worked on basic kind of code, you'd understand that palindrome checkers are one of those standard things you have to do. Anyway, what I could do, for instance, is I could echo, so I could point that to rev. What do I get? Okay, Linux in reverse. There we go. I think you'd agree, kind of pointless. Now, this one, I'm not so sure about. It's pointless, but it's also hilarious. This is SL, the typo troll. Accidentally type LS out as SL, what do you get? You summon a steam train. Check it out. I don't know. It's pointless, but I can never be mad at this, because this prank command is nothing useful except distract you. It doesn't even fix the typo, but it is here to remind us not to take life or typos too seriously. So I'd say it's 10 out of 10 for fun. It's definitely pointless, but it's still glorious. Now, finally, NL, because I can't count. I don't know. NL adds line numbers to the output of a file. It's like cat, but a bit sassier. Let's have an example here. NL with the example of text. There you go. I've now got line numbers. So most text editors already show line numbers by default. So using NL feels a bit like hiring a taxi to drive you 10 feet. It doesn't really make a lot of sense. But, you know, it is minimal, and it is there if you really hate scrolling. So pointless. Probably. So there you have it. The five most pointless, you know, somewhat redundant Linux commands. I'd love to know if some people are still using these commands on a regular basis and in what ways are they using them. Maybe they're part of some really complicated piping system with multiple commands or some old school bash script that you're still running and it just works. So why would you change it? I'd love to know. So they may not solve world hunger, but they're a reminder that Linux is full of quirks and creativity. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.